Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is Azure Storage Account. We already seen different approaches to choose what kind of data storage you can use in Azure. And it is something closely related, this topic also. And we are focusing on only one particular topic in that is Azure Storage Account. What it is, when to use it, let's try to check it out in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So Azure Storage, as the definition says, Azure selected four of the data services, right? And placed them together under the name called Azure Storage. What are those? Azure Blobs, Azure Files, Azure Queues, Azure Tables. So these four are considered as the Azure Storage. Why it is considered as a separate, combined into a single storage account is called, it's because like these four were given special treatment because they are all primitive cloud-based storage services. So they are only applicable in the cloud services, right? So these concepts are mostly closely related. And when you use an application, both should be connected, like, and they are often used together in the same application. When you build application, most of the things are you are using. If you can, you will use Blobs, Azure Queues, Azure Tables, so you will use together. So that is why they combined into a single storage, called Azure Storage. When you create Azure Storage, you can able to get all these things. Then another reason is like you want to set up some kind of settings that should applicable for all the underlying objects, right? You create 100 or 1000 blobs here, or you consider files, you need to apply certain rules or restrictions, and you cannot create individual objects. Instead, you can create at the storage account, so everything will be inherited for the underlying objects. There are many reasons, we can check it out later, but to understand you what is Azure Storage, it is a combination of all these things. And you can see here data on Azure. We have already seen our previous video the different options to store data, and it's based on your operational need and also how or what kind of data it is, like structured and unstructured. Now today's focus is on Azure Storage. As you can see, when you create an Azure account, you will able to get blob, table, file and queue storage. Let's try to see what is a storage account. So Azure Storage is one, like once you create a storage account, you will create a storage account to access the storage. That's it. So that is what a storage account is. A storage account is a container that groups set of Azure storage services together. Okay. So what are those storage services that we have seen in our previous slides? A storage account is an Azure resource and is included in the resource group. This is obvious, like any services you create that will be tagged under resource group. So storage account is also a Azure resource. Other data services like Azure SQL, Azure Cosmos DB are managed as independent Azure resources and cannot be included in the storage account. So as you can see in the previous slide, so these SQL database and Cosmos DB or any other database you create, when you create it, this will be considered as a single resource. SQL DB will be considered as a single resource. Whereas when you create Azure Storage, right, all these things comes underneath. So one, you can create Azure Storage as a single resource. That is what it is mentioned here. And those things cannot be part of the storage account. So this is the point you need to understand. The typical some of the example how you can manage the storage account is, right? So storage account belongs to resource group, and you can see all the four can be available here. And you can have a Cosmos DB, Azure SQL Web App, or other resources. These are managed as a independent resources. Whereas you can see here, you can have another resource group with the same subscription. And in this storage account, you maintain only table and blob, another storage account to maintain queues, right? So this is how you can manage based on different security purpose also, right? Some of the crucial data or business secrets can be maintained in one storage account, and another system like operational data can be stored here. So this is how you can manage your storage accounts. Now, some of the crucial properties that you need to familiar with in order to create the storage account, that is subscription. That is, for sure, any resource will be tagged under subscription for billing, billed for the services in the account. And location, the data center location or region, it will be mentioned in the portal. So which is nothing but which data center you want to store or create that account. Okay, so that we have already seen what is data centers in our introduction video, how Azure works. So they will maintain the huge data center for virtualization concept. Then there comes a performance. So you can go for standard or premium. We will go for standard in this case, right? Standard uses the magnetic disk. This is basically performance means what type of hardware disk use it to store the data, right? So standard uses the magnetic disk and premium uses the solid state drives. I hope even nowadays we go for solid state drives, SSD. And replications, which determines the strategy used to make copies of your data to protect against hardware failure or natural disaster. Basically, like when it comes to your personal PC, right? What happens when it crashes or goes or it has been broken, right? You do not, you need to put, if it is a software, you can try to recover using recovery software. But what happens when hardware fails, right? So people are feeling this is very important concept, like to understand why people should trust, how people can trust Azure is like. Microsoft or any Azure providers, they will replicate the copies, right? There are three copies maintained in the local redundant storage, meaning like your data is stored in one server one, right? There will be two more copies available in the same server or different, I mean in the same location, different server or based on different technologies, right? That we are not digging into it. Basically, whatever you store, they maintain multiple copies, and based on where it has to be stored. Locally redundant means in the same data center. Geo redundant means you can choose whether it should be within a zone or in other, some other region, some other countries, like that you can choose. Okay, if you choose a different location or geography, then definitely there will be a latency when it failure because it has to read the data from there. So this is the main concept behind it. We can choose by default it is local redundant storage, right? Access tier, this is applicable to blob storage. So it controls how quickly you will be able to access the blobs in the storage account. Hot, cool and archive. Hot means frequently you will access it, and cool means I hope there is some limitation. I mean, there are 80 days or 90 days. I will come to that later. I will cover it in detail. And archive means you will not use it more than 180 days. So it will be moved to archive. So these are the some of the properties you will set for the blob storage that we will check it out. Secure transfer required, whether it should be HTTP or HTTPS. So this is some of the properties for secure access. Then virtual network, a security feature that allows inbound access request only from the virtual networks you specify. So you can specify only from this virtual network I should get access to. So these are the crucial properties you will set while creating a storage account. I hope we will going to see that one, how to create a storage account in our next step. Let's jump into a demo. So we are in Azure portal now. I am in home page where we already created one of the resource group here in our previous video. We can see it here, it listed. Now there are different ways to create a storage account. I will go for a simplest way. Whatever listed here, it is my favorites. I mean, mostly the favorites will be listed here from the Microsoft. I mean, in this all resources, storage accounts are listed here. Now, once you go here, as usual, you start clicking on create. And as soon as you click on it, you will see like some of the options available. Create will create another page here. So this is what we can say like blades, different blades. So you will keep moving towards right. When you want to come back, you can come towards here. Just I'm making you to ensure familiar with this concept. Let me put it in full screen. Now, this is the storage account creation step. We need to choose the subscription and resource group. By default, we have only one, so it is defaulted. Now, another important name is like this storage account name should be unique across Azure, so it will not be repeated. So we will try to give AWN and its storage account one. You gave a proper name based on the some of the concepts, and you also see like it should be only lowercase letters. There won't be caps. There are some rules for each and everything as we discussed already. Like you need to check what are the prerequisite for this. I've given analytics with NAC storage account one. Then region, as we mentioned before, choose whatever the resource group you created in the same resource region if you need to put it here. And performance standard, we go for it. Just now we discuss this will be like magnetic disk, and if you choose premium, it will be in SSDs. And also redundancy, as you can see, they have put a proper definition as well: locally redundant, geo redundant, zone or geo zone redundant. These things we will cover it in separate topic. It's very important. So now I will go for locally redundant settings, then go to next. Advance, these we will come to later while I want to explain about what is data lakes and when you can use it. Just we will ignore it for now. Networking, public, let us go for a default for now. There is nothing harms us. And this is also another important factor. Now, once we discuss about the data lake storage, when to choose version 2 and when to go for V1 or blob storage, these properties I will explain it at that time. So for you to understand, just ignore this one. For very first time you are creating or you are learning about storage account, in our upcoming videos we will try to cover those properties. Tags, you can see its tags are name value pairs that enable you to categorize resources and view consolidated billing by applying the same tag. So you want to, this is used mainly for the billing purpose, right? And you can go for review and create. Just see whatever options you are given and everything is fine for you, then click on create. That will be quick. Let's wait for it. That won't take much of our time. There you go. Now we are done. Like deployment is succeed, and you can see immediately go to resource. There are various ways you can go. Let's go by simplest way. Go to resources. Yes, we are in the storage account, and you can see a different properties over here. And the important concept over here is like you can see the containers, file shares, queues and tables. So these are the things you are going to actually you are storing. Other things are some of the properties are data integration, management, security one. So where your actual data stored is over here, and underneath you have a containers. So everything under this container you can store, right? It's like whatever files or different objects you store, that should be stored under a container. And let's try to create one container. So to review, to summarize it, till now we have created one storage account underneath we need to create one container. So I'm just providing some name to store some of the files, like I will say like employee files. I'm going to upload it. As usual, you need to provide a small letter, employee files, okay? And let us leave this option right now. There are a lot of options. We will cover it later, but for now you can go for private, no anonymous access. So now we got one container. This is the container. And once you go here, there is option. Basically, like these containers and file creation usually done from a application. You build one web application that used to store the data in the blob storage or these containers, and your application can able to handle it. You write a code there, but it depends upon how your organization works. It is not always a straightforward case. That is one case I explained just now. And another case, people will try to store the data first time upload. They will try to upload the huge files or large files over here by simply dragging and dropping. There are different options. We will go for simple option right now to understand it. Now we will upload a file from my local system. Let me go to Analytics with Nags and Source Azure Files. I have one simple file that is very simple file to upload. Overwrite files exists is a default option. You can see other options, advanced options. Let's try to upload it. That's it. So it is as quick as like that. We have stored one of the file from our local drive into the Azure storage account and inside the container. Now you can click on this file and quickly see what data it contains. Like over here you can see edit. You can able to edit it. It will immediately open what are the different data over there, right? So this is, let's quickly summarize what we have done in this session. Like we have created the storage account, and inside the storage account we have created the container, and inside that container you have uploaded one of the file over here. So this is what we did, and we have seen what are the different properties and how it is important, other functionalities. There are lots of concepts and properties you should be aware. I will be trying to cover most of the concepts or properties, whichever I feel it's relevant to you or it will be useful. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and press the bell icon for notification. And do remember that data is your asset.